Well, welcome back to the program. Hey, listen, as I said, it is a live program, and sometimes, where am I again? Am I facing Northwest? Okay, very good. I don't know what that means. Right? I know you all have been waiting with bated breath. Italy is one of my favorite countries. So I know Steve, yes. He still doesn't know. That's why Maxine Albert is here. Hello, Maxine. Welcome to the program.
Thank you, Eric.
Thank you so much for going to Italy on our last trip. And I wish I could have gone, but we had to send a professional instead. That'd be you.
It was my pleasure.
It was okay?
It was hard work, but, you know,
Somebody has to do it.
Exactly.
You know, how long have you been a travel writer?
Oh, it seems I've been for quite a while, a number of years.
Yeah. Long enough to know you should know better. You know, don't people come up to you and say all the time, they say, you have the greatest job ever. And it's true.
They say that, and you know what? It's true.
It is true.
It is true.
Yeah. I mean, as many complaints as we might think we have, we really don't. Because to get to go to places and write about them and report on them is a pretty good gig, wouldn't you say?
And eat the food and see the sights and get paid for it.
Well, I wasn't going to rub it in, Maxine. I didn't want to make them feel bad, no.
Yes, yeah. I'm lucky.
It's pretty good.
It's pretty great.
Have you been to this part of, we're going to talk today about Lazio.
Oh, okay.
Now, had you been before?
Actually, Lazio is technically the outskirts of Tuscany, Umbria, Rome, and the sea coast.
Okay.
West of Rome.
Got it. Okay.
So I have not been to the sea coast, so it was new for me, which is fantastic.
Yeah, because it's a big world. You're always going to new places.
And I like to go to new places. When I go to some place that I haven't been before, it's always wonderful.
Well, now, did you bring pictures today?
I did.
I love pictures. I love pictures. Okay, good. So can we run them through? Do you mind?
Oh, sure, please.
All right. What are we starting with here? What are we looking at? Do you know what you're looking at?
Oh, yes, I know what I'm looking at.
It's
not in the order that I thought. Okay.
You were on this trip. Is this from your trip?
This is from my trip. Okay.
Okay.
This is Sperlonga.
Okay.
Okay.
All right.
And the thing about Sperlonga is that it's considered the most beautiful part of Italy, the most beautiful town in Italy.
Oh, wow.
Yes, and you can see here, it's built on a hill.
Yep.
It was built by Tiberius, and it was built to keep out pirates.
Oh, okay. Well, yeah, as my home is. I mean, I don't want the pirates, you know, that's bad. Okay, what's next?
Okay.
Oh, look at this. This is gorgeous.
This is actually the beach area of Sperlonga.
That's unbelievable.
Isn't it beautiful?
That's the thing. We were talking about this on the phone. It's very hard to describe places that are just gorgeous. I mean, you look at a place like this, you go, how do you say what that is other than unbelievable?
Well, the amazing thing about this is that when you go through Europe, you're usually on beaches that are pebble beaches. So they have beautiful, pristine, white, sandy beaches. They have gorgeous hotels. You have the blue Mediterranean. And you have, it's totally authentic. You don't have the tourists there.
Yeah, I was going to say, this is not exactly a marquee destination for tourists, correct?
Exactly. The people who go there are the Romans who go there and the people from Naples. So it's really an authentic place to go.
Okay. Next.
Okay. This is the Mentoro. And the Mentoro is, you know, it's one thing to read about runes in a book, but when you're actually feeling them, you're actually in the place and you're feeling the history.
Yeah.
So this is a town on a hill. The town is Mentoro, and the runes are Mentorno. And there's an architectural amphitheater there.
Mm-hmm.
You have an aqueduct. You see the actual things where people, there's, you know, a theater where you can actually go during the summer and see the summer recitals of music there.
Mm-hmm.
And then it's also, the Appian Way crosses it, which is the oldest road in Rome, so it's really amazing.
Oh, wow. What airline did you fly?
Flew Alitalia, which starts the experience right away. You know, you have
Love
the Italian
that.
Food, Italian wine, good-looking Italian people.
Mm-hmm.
Which is fun.
And you flew into Rome?
Into Rome and then traveled about an hour. You can go an hour by train to Lazio.
Okay. Over the years, have you found a different time of year in Italy, better or worse? Or do you have a favorite time of year to visit Italy?
Well, you know, the time of year that most people go is during the summer, which is when it's the most crowded, and you don't always get to see the great things. So mm-hmm. when I went, which is about a month ago, it's really nice because it wasn't crowded. You could really experience everything and enjoy it. And mm-hmm. I think you should go anytime.
All right. I like that. You got a couple more photos before we go?
Okay.
Do you mind? Because I love the photos. They're always fun to take.
Okay.
Oh, look at this thing.
Oh, this is interesting. Now, this is the Turk's Grotto. And the story about this is that it's actually a split mountain. And the
really?
Myth about that, you see both sides is a mountain, but the myth about it is that when Christ died, there was an earthquake that split the mountain.
Right.
And there was a Turkish man who didn't believe it, so he put his hand on the mountain and he said, if it's true, may it all turn to liquid. And it did, so you can actually see the handprint. And this is the grotto there that goes all the way down into the sea, which is 300 steps down.
Oh,
so
my.
You can take, if you see down there, I think that's me at the bottom.
Yes, I can see you down there.
Yeah, you can see it's me right there.
Yeah, you got your yellow polka dot bikini on.
Exactly. So you go 300 steps down and 300 steps up, which makes you have a great appetite.
Yeah, I was going to say, no need to go to the gym.
Exactly.
What are you going to be heading back to Italy anytime soon, do you know?
I hope so. The thing about going to a place the first time is that the first time you get to see it, and the second time you get to even see more places. So maybe I'll go back to Lazio again.
Yeah, I think that sounds like a great idea. I like that idea. Will you come back and do other reports for us?
I definitely will.
I would like that. You seem like you're someone's fun to hang out with.
Okay. Well, I agree.
Well, there you go. All right, very good. Well, we will continue this series on Italy next week here on the program, so we'll have another installment. I can't wait.
Me either.
I'm looking forward to it. All right, we'll be back in just a second. Stay with us on Travel Show Live.